So fine, we know what basically is RDD. Now let's see where will these RDD come from. We have to create it as per our requirement. So what are the ways that we can create these RDDs? First way they are telling is parallelizing an existing collection in your driver program. What are collections? Collections are basically a set of values that we can use, something like arrays, list, sequence. So if you have a collection, let's say I have a collection, let's say val data is, I have an array with different numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This can be anything. So we have our data with 5 values and we have it in array. So array we are referring here as collection. So we can create an RDD out of this particular object, that is a collection array, by parallelizing it. We'll go through it. Or the second way of creating an RDD is creating a data set in an external storage system, that such as shared file system, HDFS, HBase. So these are the two ways that we can create an RDD. External source, just to confirm, it is some extra, this could be some external file or in your distributed file system or any of your database like HBase. So data could be anywhere and we can create RDD out of that. So for parallelizing, let's go through it. We can use sc.parallelize and pass our collection into it, and this will return us an RDD. We have a data here, and if we use sc, sc stands for whatever Spark context we created, dot parallelize, and we'll pass our data, that is our collection. Let me assign this to a val that will be our RDD. Parallelized RDD is sc.parallelize. So we have created our RDD out of a collection. So what went into this RDD? To see that, we have to use any operation. So just to give a small background, because we are starting from scratch, so what is operation? Basically, Spark RDDs provide us two kinds of operation, that is a transformation and action. So as of now, you can have a small idea, like when you do any operation on an RDD, that is our distributed data set, all those operations step by step will be recorded until and unless whatever operation you are doing is a transformation. No action will be done. And if you perform an action on that, all those transformations that you did will be computed as per your transformations that you did, and final result will be thrown. So basically, you cannot see any output out of RDD operations if you are not calling an action. So right now I'm not doing anything, but I want to see the output. So anyhow, I have to call an action. And one small action as of now is collect. So if we call parallelize RDD dot collect, and for each value that it provides, we have to call a println for each println. Fine. So if you understood the basic theory that I just gave, you can go with that. Otherwise, just keep in mind, if you have to print the output of an RDD, you have to do that RDD.collect.forEachPrintLn. Fine. Let me try to execute this. It will take some time in the first run. So out of all the logs, if I scroll up, I can see I have all the elements that were there in my collection 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are now there in PAR RDD, that is our RDD. So let's move on. And once you have this RDD, you can do different operation, whatever the data was there. Like a simple operation is reduce. If you want to reduce, basically does the operation on all the elements. Like here they are using reduce a comma b gives a plus b. So what does this mean? Reduce function takes a pattern that you can expect into an RDD, that is any values, something like any values that are occurring, you have to return the addition of all those values. So let's see what this gives us. So now I don't want to print it. What I want to do is par RDD dot reduce, and a comma b gives us a plus b. So here you can see we actually didn't get any output because after reduce we didn't use println. So So we can use println and this entire output. You can see here we are getting the sum of all these values. One thing to notice here is I used reduce. So first thing that can be asked is reduce an action? Why without any, as some of might you get confused in reduce and reduce by key, that is going to come in when we will deal with the data frames and paired RDDs. So yes, reduce is considered as an action, but reduce by key is a transformation. So don't get confused. Also in reduce, if you just have to add just an additional information I'm giving you, you don't need to mention the pattern like this, because whatever is there in this RDD as per this scenario, we have to add everything. So in Scala, we can do it like underscore, that means everything, and you have to add with everything. So this is a small way to do whatever we did just now. Close the print bracket, and if I run this, then also I'll get the same output.